Claims data offers an expansive view of a patient's health history. Specifically, claims data include information on demographics, medical history, and medications. They offer insights regarding a patient's risk, and as we will demonstrate, they reveal indicative signals and patterns. We'll use health insurance claims filled for about 7,000 members from January 2000 until November 2007. We concentrated on members with the following attributes: at least 5 claims with coronary artery disease diagnosis, at least 5 claims with hypertension diagnostic codes, at least 100 total medical claims, at least 5 pharmacy claims, and data from at least 5 years. These selections yield patients with a high risk of heart attack and a reasonably rich medical history with continuous coverage. Let us discuss how we aggregated this data. The resulting data set includes about 20 million health insurance entries, including individual medical and pharmaceutical records. Diagnosis, procedures, and drug codes in the data set comprise tens of thousands of attributes. The codes were aggregated into groups: 218 diagnosis groups, 180 procedure groups, 538 drug groups. 46 diagnosis groups were considered by clinicians as possible risk factors for heart attacks. Let us discuss how we view the data over time. It is important in the study to view the medical records chronologically and to represent a patient's diagnosis profile over time. So, we record the cost and number of medical claims and hospital visits by a diagnosis. All the observations we had spanned over 5 years of data. They were split into 21 periods, each 90 days in length. We examined 9 months of diagnostic history leading up to heart attack or no heart attack event, and aligned the data to make observations that are data dependent, independent, while preserving the order of events. We recorded the diagnostic history in 3 periods: 0 to 3 months before the event, 3 to 6 months before the event, and 6 to 9 months before the event. What was the target variable we're trying to predict? The target prediction variable is the occurrence of a heart attack. We define this from a combination of several claims, namely diagnosis of a heart attack alongside a trip to the emergency room followed by a subsequent hospitalization. Only considering heart attack diagnoses that are associated with a visit to the emergency room and follow-on hospitalization helps ensure that the target outcome is in fact a heart attack event. The target variable is binary. It is denoted by +1 or -1 for the occurrence or non-occurrence of a heart attack in the targeted period of 90 days. How is the data organized? There were 147 variables. Variable 1 is the patient's identification number, and variable 2 is the patient's gender. There were variables related to the diagnosis group counts, 9, 6, and 3 months before the heart attack target period. There were variables related to the total cost, 9, 6, and 3 months before the heart attack target period. And the final variable, 147, includes the classification of whether the event was a heart attack or not. Cost of medical care is a good summary of a person's health. In our database, the total cost of medical care in the 3 90-day periods preceding the heart attack target event ranged from $0 to $636,000, and approximately 70% of the overall cost was generated by only 11% of the population. This means that the high-risk patients with high medical expenses are a very small proportion of the data and could skew our final results. According to the American Medical Association, only 10% of individuals have projected medical expenses of approximately $10,000 or greater per year, which is more than 4 times greater than the average projected medical expense of $2,400 per year. To lessen the effects of these high-cost outliers, we divided the data into different cost buckets based on the findings of the American Medical Association. We did not want to have too many cost bins because of the size of the dataset. The table in the slide gives a summary of the cost bucket partitions. Patients with expenses over $10,000 in the 9-month period were allocated to cost bucket 3. Patients with less than $2,000 in expenses were allocated to cost bucket 1, and the remaining patients with costs between $2,000 and $10,000 to cost bucket 2. Please note that the majority of patients, 4,400 out of 6,500, or 67.5% of all patients, fell into the first bucket of low expenses.